Hey guys, Blazing Wrath here, and today I'm going to take an in-depth look at MCC's challenge system, season rewards, and the exchange that has been added into MCC's latest update, and how these three features relate to Halo Infinite. So let's start off with MCC's challenge system. The challenge system in MCC is pretty good. This keeps players engaged in playing the game and gives them reasons to come back to the game every week to earn XP or season points. Every season so far up to this point has exclusive season cosmetic unlocks and can only be earned by challenges. Unfortunately, these particular challenges don't offer any season points whatsoever, but the point of these challenges is to earn exclusive cosmetic rewards. I'm assuming 343 doesn't want to give any season points to the gold challenges in the seasonal challenge section, because players already get enough points just by doing other challenges elsewhere, especially in the seasonal challenge section. So, how does this feature relate to Halo Infinite? Well, to me, this is a no shit type of feature that should be included into Halo Infinite day one. A lot of fans have been asking 343 to include challenges in their games since Halo 5, because that game had no challenge unlocks whatsoever. All the unlocks were locked behind an RNG card system, so the cosmetics you earned and have no meaning or sense of accomplishment to them. The player's only way to get unlocks in Halo 5 was just to hopefully get lucky and open a card pack that contains a bunch of shit that very little people will care about. Now thankfully there are no duplicates involved when opening these packs, so you're guaranteed new items each time you open a pack, but my point still stands. Ever since Halo 5, 343 has made a great decision and brought back challenges into Halo Wars 2 and added them into MCC. So hopefully we should expect challenges to make a return once again into Halo Infinite. We should also thank Bungie for introducing this feature that was added into Halo Reach back in 2010. Next, let's talk about MCC's season rewards and how the system works. MCC's season rewards work very similarly to the very popular Battle Pass system introduced by Fortnite. Ever since Fortnite introduced the Battle Pass system, many other games have followed this trend, such as the past three Call of Duty games, Apex Legends, and even its former competitor, PUBG. This isn't a terrible unlock system, but this clearly has flaws with the way game devs and publishers have been handling them. Now before we talk any further about MCC's Battle Pass system, let me explain how other games do them. For starters, the Battle Pass system in other games normally costs money. Now there are a few unlocks within the Battle Pass that are free, but players have to pay at least $10, usually, to get access to the rest of the cosmetics contained within the Battle Pass, which usually contains 100 unlocks, commonly known as tiers. There's also usually a second option where players can pay $20 to get a 25 tiers out of 100 from the start. Even when players do purchase the Battle Pass, there is a third option where you can pay $1 for each tier individually, but you must pay the initial $10 or $20 to get access to the Battle Pass first before players can do that option, which can potentially cost around $100 to $110 in total, depending on which option the player purchased. So to sum up the flaw I just explained, is that this system usually costs money. Sure, after you pay the minimum requirement of $10, you can grind through the rest of the tiers just by playing the game. Chances are, though, that grind will most likely be very tedious and long to grind out, because obviously game devs and publishers intentionally do that to encourage players to purchase the Battle Pass and all the tiers within them rather than grinding them out. The second flaw with the system is that they normally only last for 1 to 2 months. After that, the Battle Pass for that specific time frame disappears forever and is replaced with a new Battle Pass with a fresh new set of 100 tiers, and the cycle repeats, meaning that players can miss out on some unlocks even if they didn't pay for them or didn't grind them hard enough. Once in a while, you will see some unlocks that you might have missed out reappear in the in-game store, but chances are that unlock is now bundled with something else and costs a bit more than $10. So, the second flaw here in what I just explained is that players can miss out on unlocks and may have to pay more money for pieces of cosmetics they missed out in the in-game store. Now that you know how a Battle Pass system normally works, let's take a look at how MCC does it. As you can see, 343 doesn't call this a Battle Pass, rather they call them Season Rewards. Different name, but still the same structure as a Battle Pass. However, even though MCC's been out since 2014, I think 343 is aware about the existence of Battle Pass systems, and more importantly, their flaws. For one, 343's Season Rewards don't cost any money, so their system is completely free. The only way to unlock their tiers is by strictly through gameplay. One improvement over the typical Battle Pass system I forgot to mention is that every page you see me cycling here can be unlocked in any order, whereas in every other Battle Pass system is strictly linear and players have to pay or grind through them in number order. So every page here in the Season Rewards contain 10 cosmetic unlocks and can be spent by in-game currency known as Season Points in any order. Again, no real-world money is involved here. Players still have to spend 10 Season Points in each page in order to move on to the next page, however. Still an improvement, no doubt. The next improvement over other Battle Passes is that once a season ends in MCC, players can still progress through previous season rewards, as you can see here. This means players won't miss out on any unlocks and have the freedom to spend Season Points wherever players want. So overall, MCC's season reward system is a major improvement over any other Battle Pass system that's out there. The only game that I can think of that rivals MCC's season rewards is Doom Eternal, which is also completely free. Now how does all that jargon I just explained tie in with Halo Infinite? Well, since Battle Passes are a trend that doesn't look like it's stopping anytime soon, Halo Infinite will no doubt have a Battle Pass system of its own, just like any other mainstream shooter these days. All we can do is hope that 343 does a better job with the system, with Halo Infinite, than every other game that's out there besides Doom Eternal. Lastly, let's quickly talk about the in-game store that, once again, a lot of mainstream shooters have these days. Usually a lot of them are just crap that no one will care about and cost around $10 to $25. MCC's The Exchange feature is no doubt a test for the feature, except nothing costs money. Make no mistake, Halo Infinite's in-game store will cost real money. We can only hope that the prices will be cheaper than other games. Now that's it for today, guys. I normally don't talk about MCC too often, but I decided to make an exception, because I believe the features I just talked about relate to Halo Infinite to some capacity. I still believe, in all honesty, that Halo Infinite's Battle Pass system will cost $10, and I'm kind of okay with that. Remember, Halo Infinite's multiplayer is going to play free-to-play, so 343 and Microsoft have to make back some money in return, since it's a free-to-play model. Much like how MCC's season rewards are getting added onto every 2 months, hopefully Halo Infinite will follow suit with MCC in how they just keep adding season rewards every 2 months and they never go away. That way nobody will miss out on content. I'm confident that Halo Infinite will have a good challenge system, much like MCC and Halo Wars 2. Well, if you enjoyed this video, a like and a share would be very much appreciated. And until next time, peace.